I'm just about to bounce on him. I'm just about to bounce on him. .404.
Unreal.
We're sort of on time.
As close on time as we've ever been.
Ever. Ever. This is Coach and Rob, Sports Biz Podcast, July something.
16?
16. And we got a bunch to talk about.
And we know you missed us.
Yeah.
We missed you.
We did. What's going on?
Exactly.
What's going on?
Exactly.
Right. Yeah. So we got a bunch to talk about. We got another top 11.
Top 11.
We got a top 11.
Don't worry. There's 11.
We got 11. We got some sports stuff to cover as well. And we got a little top 11. So get ready. Let's see. As far as housekeeping, if you want to watch us, subscribe to YouTube channel Rob Thompson Live, and all the shows are on there, as well as obviously on Facebook, and then on Anchor at Sports Biz Podcast is on Anchor. Is how you find us. We're gonna be taking the show on the road to the Blue Horse come August. Now it's not July. It's
your seatbelts.
Could you believe? First of all, could you believe that July is like halfway? It's freaking unbelievable. Why does this summer go so fast every year?
I feel like after the 4th of July, summer is in effect, effectively over.
My father says the same thing.
I do. I feel like effectively it's...
No.
It's over.
Yeah. That's it.
I could be wrong. I don't know. I just feel...
Well, you know, the best part is the kids... My kids go back to school after Labor Day.
Upstate
New York. So the summer's still the summer. You're not thinking. We get the full summer.
Right.
Yeah. But, and it's good too, because that last week of August, everybody's back to school. So,
yeah,
you know,
well,
going
we,
places,
we
go down to
here.
The beach. Yeah, yeah. It's awesome. So, anyway, right. Sports Biz Podcast presented by Game Plan U. I do have an announcement. So, I am hosting a Sports Biz Startup Weekend in Orlando. January 2020, and that's going to be for entrepreneurs, startups, startovers, career seekers, investors. We're going to have a bunch of great guest speakers within the industry, and if you go to my website, you can find out more information on that. So we'll probably be broadcasting some shows down there if Coach could sneak away.
It's going to be tough.
But anyway, so let's get into it. Jamie, how you doing, buddy? Frank Ward, how you doing?
Those loyal listeners.
Oh,
I mean,
man.
That's on their fantastic.
Because
they're
just waiting to hear what's going to come out of your mouth. That's why. So.
Yeah. I think I drive the ratings by the people who love it.
Yes.
And can't wait to hear what I'm going to say. And the people who hate me.
Yes.
Or the show and the concept.
Yeah.
Who can't wait to hear what I say,
right? That's
right. So, whatever. Yeah. What's the difference?
Doesn't matter. All right. So, we got some subjects you want to talk about.
Let's start with a guy I can't describe this guy, but let's start with him. LeVar Ball.
Oh.
Currently banned from ESPN. I guess this is my question. Does this help or hurt LeVar Ball? Because it still keeps him controversial, still keeps him relevant. You just got banned from arguably one of the biggest sport networks, right?
I don't know how it could help him out. I mean,
what's there to help, I guess, right?
Yeah, that's just...
How would you describe LeVar Ball? Someone said, hey, give me your quick description of what LeVar Ball is. What would you say? I was thinking about this the other day.
A narcissistic sociopath.
Yes.
How's that?
Combined with overbearing psychotic parent?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Who has talented sons?
Yeah. 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 He doesn't even make any sense.
No.
When he talks.
No. And apparently he got banned, I should say, for some quasi-sexual reference, right, to a female...
Is that what happened?
...reporter. Yeah. Something about switching gears.
Yeah.
Is that it?
You know, the worst part about it is he also makes his kids unlikable.
Yeah, that is a problem.
Right? And I think, you know, as a coach, if you don't like the parent, chances are you're not going to like the kid either.
It's very hard to differentiate.
Is it?
But... The one thing I will say, as a coach, when you're with the player, as many hours of the day that we are, it's easier. You know what the kid really is. You know the guy on your team and the guy in your program, how he really is. And fortunately, I can say this. Unfortunately, there are so many players that I've coached in the past that I don't hold it against them for how mom or dad might act or things they've done. I don't. Because, again, I don't have just a snapshot. I spend a lot of hours with them. So I have that luxury. But if you don't, it's guilt by association. No question. Yeah. I mean, it makes it tough, but I really try to separate it, you know, because I think I think if you're younger, AAU level, youth league, it's really tough. But they kind of become their own person when 18 to 22, you know, like they kind of say, like, please do not listen to my dad or my mom. They're nuts. Like, so, you know, like, right?
Yeah, my parents are insane.
Don't
even listen to them.
I mean, most 18 to 22 year olds think that to begin with.
Right.
But, you know, so I do think it doesn't help. It just doesn't help.
So he's been barred. He's done.
That's what they say.
Yeah.
That's what they say.
Well, what's his story? What is his backstory? He was a player in the league, wasn't he?
I don't know if he played in the NBA. No. He did say he could beat Michael Jordan one-on-one or anybody else.
He's ridiculous.
I don't think he played in the NBA. Did
he play over in Europe?
Maybe. We don't fact check here.
There's zero fact checking.
He talks like he's in Springfield in the Hall of Fame.
You're right.
But I don't. You're right.
Right.
Like, so I don't think he played. Yeah. I could be wrong. I don't follow. He's one of those guys that just doesn't grab my attention because it's just so stupid to me and so bizarre that.
Yeah.
And your son's in the NBA.
Right.
And was a
you won.
He was a lottery pick. Am I wrong on that?
Fact checking again. Who
definitely
knows?
First rounder.
Right. Yeah.
Because he was a first round pick of the Lakers. What, two years ago? Maybe 3 years ago. Played at UCLA. Right.
Yeah.
Had that weird looking jump shot. I came out with the Baller brand. Right. The sneakers that were like $800.
Right.
That no one bought.
Right. Yeah. Flopped.
Well. All that said, he's barred.
Yeah.
ESPN no
Love
longer
it.
An option.
Big round of applause for ESPN.
I like it.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah.
You don't have to go home, LeVar, but you can't stay
here.
See ya. Next.
What do you got?
We spoke last episode about the women's national soccer team, equal pay, all those issues.
100%.
Procter & Gamble.
Yeah.
I guess on behalf of Secret Deodorant, the brand Secret, which is a female product, donates $529,000 to the team, which doles out to $23,000 per player. What do you think about that?
After taxes, they're
good. Yeah, right.
About $15,000.
Yeah. Give or take, depending on what state.
You know, first of all, brilliant move.
Correct.
And the reason why is because you and I are sitting here talking about
exactly
it right now. So if they're going to dump $500,000, $500,000 in any type of advertisement,
they're going to make it back in a week.
Right. So their media value that they just received is probably $30 million.
My first question was, when I saw that,
why
didn't someone beat them to the punch?
Yeah. So everybody else was sleeping.
Yep.
Everybody else was sleeping.
I'd love to see the numbers at the end of the year.
Yeah. You know what? It probably started quickly with a text.
Yeah.
It probably was a CMO saying... Or somebody, it could have been someone on a lower level within that brand that said, boy, wouldn't it be cool if we do something in sponsorship? Real. Well, what else do we do? Well, let's just give them $500,000.
Right.
Let's divide it up.
It's a hot topic right now.
Yeah.
It'll go right to their salary.
Yeah. Right. It's just a brilliant move by them. Now, here's the key. It's going to be interesting to see, just from a sponsorship brand perspective and integration into what they've just done as a goodwill.
Yeah.
Now, what's their follow-up to that?
Yeah.
What's the brand's follow-up to that? Now, how do they use the money? What does it go to? Do they donate the money? Do they, what do they use it for? That would be a cool thing if they could get a couple of the players to talk about what an impact it made, that even if it was $15,000,
Correct. Did
it make a real impact on their life?
Right.
In some way.
Or is it just to get involved in the fight?
Right. Did it help? How impactful was that to them personally?
Yes.
And I think that is now, if they all took that $500,000 and said, let's throw it in a pot and let's put it towards something.
Let's bet on a horse.
Let's come to Saratoga and let's just let it ride.
Wouldn't it be great if one of them was like, I took the money and blew it in one weekend in Vegas.
Right.
So I had to wait. I have to pay tax on that?
Right.
Like, I wouldn't that be? I think that would be great. Like,
now they went down to Atlantic City. Casey.
Yeah.
We got Atlantic City and Ocean's Resort.
Anytime the invite comes our way.
We're ready for it. We're ready to bring the show down there.
Oh, God. Yeah. Talk about bringing the crowd.
I know. Casey, August 2nd and 3rd, I'll be down there. Be down there playing in a golf tournament. We're ready to go.
I could be down there August 2nd and 3rd if need be.
Yeah.
I'll just throw that out there.
Yeah.
Just going to throw
all
it out
right.
there.
I love it. So anyways, to close up that subject, I think it's a brilliant move by them. I'm interested to see the follow-up to it. How could they leverage the momentum that they have now?
Yes.
You know, so now do they go down to provide scholarships for, you know, for support? They may be a sponsor of USA Youth Soccer. I don't know.
I don't know either.
They probably are. If they're already thinking that way, and if it's not something that's completely off their radar.
They already have a hook in.
They already probably have a hook in. So they may be a sponsor of that. Again, we don't do any fact-checking, right? So
nor will we.
No. Yeah.
But I also thought about this the other day. Women's soccer in the U.S. is probably more influential on a youth level than men's by far, right?
Without a doubt. And they're better.
Yeah.
They're better than a man.
So whoever gets involved and puts their stamp on them, especially right now, it's a gold mine.
It's a gold mine.
So.
Right?
100%.
You know, it's just like growing up when we watched the U.S. men's hockey team.
Right.
When in Lake Placid in 77?
No fact
78?
Checking.
78?
No fact checking.
Somebody knows that one. Montesi, Hoban, one of you guys know. When did the U.S. men's hockey team win? 76, 77, 78, somewhere around there. But that would make an impact.
Yes.
You know, a lot of young kids, myself, that just fell in love with hockey after that. Same thing with youth soccer.
So then, if we were to say to them, we would love to have the whole team down as our special guest when we do go to Atlantic City.
Yeah.
We could jump right on this bandwagon.
Exactly. That's an idea.
Get us a couple suites.
Right.
We'll lock them all in.
Jason? Yep.
Yeah, bring them on the show.
Right. We'll spend your $23,000 for bonus from...
We'll show you a great time.
We'll show you a great time.
Show you a great time.
1980. It was 1980.
Bring it all. Bring it all in big bills if you can.
Yeah.
All 23 grand.
Yeah.
We'll worry about... Uncle Sam will take care of him after.
Right.
All big bills.
All big bills. Right.
That's it.
Yeah. Line of credits. Any line of credits?
You got to use your star power when you can. We'll probably get you an open line.
Right.
We'll hook you up.
They got a Wahlburgers down there at...
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
I'm assuming that will be provided on the arm, as they say.
Yeah,
for
on
us.
The arm would be all the burgers you can eat, Thompson.
Yeah, I mean, they could do something with that.
Yeah.
On the arm.
All right. So women's soccer, put that to bed. Congratulations.
Yeah.
They got even more money out of it.
Yes.
That might be a windfall for them now.
Maybe it opens the floodgates.
Maybe it opens the floodgates. Yeah.
I agree.
You see Bill Gates step up or want to, you know, step up and donate.
There's tons of guys with tons of money.
Yeah.
Who are bored.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And want something new.
Right.
And probably want something worthwhile.
Get behind it.
Which this probably is. So, you know.
All right.
That'll do it for sports.
That'll do it for sports.
Thanks for tuning in.
As we come out of the sports section, the sports section theme song.
Now we get the white meat.
Yeah.
As they say.
Yeah. All right. So we got a top 10, top 11?
Not that we oppose dark meat.
That's right. Yeah, so.
Well, first things first, little sidebar. Blair Witch Project, did you see it?
I did see it.
Most people did, right?
Yeah, yeah, and it haunted me for a while.
20 years.
Yeah.
20th anniversary is this week, I think Monday.
Yeah.
Hold on, hold the thought.
Wahlburgers, Burgers Unreal, Mac and Cheese Smoked Bacon Burger. And then a side of defibrillator.
You had me at Mac.
The side of
you didn't need to finish. You don't even need to finish.
Heart attack. That sounds awesome. Yeah, I'm sorry. So Blair Witch. First of all, let's say this. Now you growing up in Long Island, where there are a lot of woods around you.
Where I was, yes.
Yeah. All right.
Yes, but it became heavily populated as I grew up.
Yeah. All right.
My parents first got there. It was all farmland.
So would you say that you're a little bit afraid of the woods at night? Like right now, currently?
Right now? Well, it depends where I am, but I know where you're getting at. Like, I remember walking home in my early years and even in my teen years from, like, friends' houses and having to cut through the woods at night.
Petrified.
There was an issue.
Yeah.
That was an issue.
Yeah.
Like, I went as fast as I could, tried not to fall down,
yeah.
get out the other side where there were streetlights, and all right, everything's good.
it.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yes.
I'm not gonna lie. I'm even
still petrified now.
I don't know. Petrified. Scared. I'm a little scared.
We didn't have cell phones then.
My mind thinks Freddy Krueger's out here. Blair Witch is out here. That crazy thing from the village is out here. There's something out here in the woods that's waiting for me.
Talk about a genius movie, The Village. I always say this.
Phenomenal.
They lived on a highway.
Yeah.
But they thought they lived in like Williamsburg, Colonial Virginia.
No idea. Right? How about the greatest thing is they changed the routing of the planes.
Unbelievable.
Right? And they bought into it.
Yeah. Well, and you can trick anyone into anything if you do it right.
Yeah. Well, right. That was a Shyamalama-lama movie.
Oh, yeah.
That was a Shyamalama-lama.
M. Night Shyamalan.
Yeah. That was a Shyamalan. That was one.
That's when he was cranking them out.
Yeah,
the one with the fairy or the that was in the pool of the apartment complex with Paul Giamatti. Remember that?
Oh, that's right.
I remember what it's called.
Yeah. I don't know. He just came out with another movie.
He did recently. Yeah. 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 I can't remember what it is, but.
Yeah.
Those are movies that even if someone tells me how bad it is, I'm going to go see because he thinks from a different lens.
He does.
So to speak.
Doc Brown, how you doing, buddy? Really Bad Rum, the founder and owner of Really Bad Rum. Yeah. Jimmy Montesi, you guys got to jump on that rum. Yeah. Really Bad Rum. How you doing, Doc?
So we will gladly accept all free bottles.
The Doc is a real life pirate, by the way. Yeah, life pirate.
Then he's definitely a friend of mine.
Yeah, real life pirate.
So Blair Witch, which till today, till this day, scares you.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I mean, that final scene, you know, and then the
when he's standing, when he's standing with his back to the,
brilliant.
Yeah.
Brilliant movie. I mean, the great thing about it is even the PR they put out about it, you didn't even actually, the PR about it was that this was a video that they kind of like.
Stumbled on. Yes.
So you didn't even know if it was a real movie.
It was very murky waters. Yeah. Is it real? Is it not real?
Right.
So, but truth be told.
Sailor Jerry, son. Yeah, I love Sailor Jerry. Sorry.
Truth be told, though, there was a bunch of kids in the woods with two jamokes like us holding the camera the whole time. Like, it was everything staged, everything.
Yeah.
$60,000 was the budget. It grossed $250 million.
Unbelievable.
Has to be the most successful independent film ever, I would assume.
Yeah.
If it's not, then please let me know. That's...
Yeah.
So return on investment, they did pretty good.
They
did
pretty well on that one. Yeah, they did pretty well on that
20
one.
Years old. Wow. We're not getting younger, is this?
No.
So, now to get down to it, right? Let's get down to it.
So do we have a top 10?
Top 10, this was a request from a loyal listener.
All right. So, do they know that we don't do top 10s, we do 11s?
Yes, but we still, the working title is always top 10.
All right, so let me go with our top 10. Let me go a little...
Theme music?
Let me go a little top 10 music. So we're taking requests on the top 10s, top 11s. You got to have a bonus one in there.
Yeah, there's always an honorable mention.
You have to have a participation trophy.
And I got a good one for this one.
All right. All right, so what's the top 10?
So we have the top 10 athletes who went on to become actors or actresses.
In movies.
But I believe today it's just actors, right? We got rid of actress.
So they're all actors.
Is that right?
Yeah,
I think
is.
That's right, right?
It
okay.
Is.
So
right.
Who went on to become actors.
Right.
Top 10 athletes. Now, there are more than you think, number one. I did this list to the best of either trying to counterbalance the entertainment career and the athletic career.
Yeah.
I tried to get the best of both worlds, if possible. So again, this is my top 10, not anyone else's. However, I tried to do as much equality as I could.
Yeah.
So I didn't. Here's what you're not going to see. You're not going to see a guy who played high school basketball and won a state championship and went on to make movies. You're not going to see that. It needs bare bones, major college athletics or pro level athletics.
Gotcha. So these
minimum.
These are stars that you know.
Yo, you're going to know everyone on this list, but the criteria for me was major high-end college athletics. I'm talking Power 5 football conferences. I'm talking highest of the high-end in college for the most part.
Yeah.
Or pro experience.
Okay.
So if they played any level of pro sports,
all right,
you're on this list.
All right, good.
And you had a semi-accomplished to very accomplished acting career. Not a one-off on Different Strokes. Not a, you know, Alpo dog food commercial. I'm talking, you are working. You have a Screen Actors Guild card. You paid dues.
You're legit.
You are a working actor.
You're legit.
Okay?
So, in the spirit of movies, a little Hollywood Nights.
Nothing better.
All right.
So, I have an honorable mention. Number 11.
All right.
As I always do.
Participation award. This is our participation award.
As I always do. This gentleman, I would classify him as a new and current style actor. Athlete turned actor. Terry Crews. Do you know who that is?
I do.
Terry Crews.
Terry Crews. Office linebacker.
Correct.
Yeah.
Office linebacker, which is fantastic.
Beyond fantastic. That was one of the greatest commercial, right?
Did the Old Spice campaign, right?
Yep. That's right.
In very, very good shape.
Yeah.
Has appeared in, I think, Brooklyn Nine, whatever it's called.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm thinking Terry Tate.
No, Terry Tate is office linebacker.
Oh, office linebacker.
This is Terry Crews.
Yeah, he was a defensive back.
Played linebacker.
Linebacker, yeah.
11th round pick in 1991.
Yeah.
In the NFL. Had a cup of coffee.
Yeah.
But got drafted.
Yeah.
Right?
Right. It was legit.
Did that whole Old Spice campaign. Is 100% recognizable as an actor, right?
Yeah.
He made my honorable mention.
Number 11.
I think it's fair.
It is
He's
fair.
He's number 11.
Yeah.
Now, before I get to the top 10, I had someone I didn't know what to do with.
Yeah.
So this person, this gentleman, does not appear on the top 10, but I'm bringing him up because I didn't know what to do with him. Arnold Schwarzenegger.
How does he not make your top 10?
Well, here, I'm going to tell you why.
Right.
I don't know, and I know I'm going to get some flack for this, and I hope I do, because guess what? The fans don't boo nobodies. Remember that. I don't know where to put bodybuilding. I don't know what box to put that in. I hate putting things in boxes anyway, but
yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. He's very accomplished from an actor and from the showbiz side of things, from government.
He was what do they call the world champions in
boxing? Oh, no, he was Mr. Universe.
Universe.
He was probably the best bodybuilder of all time.
He came over from Austria.
But do you know how he started? Came over from Austria.
Right.
Do you know how he started his whole life here? Well, they had a huge earthquake in California. Him and a bunch of other jacked Austrian dudes came over here and just started a...
lifting cars?
No, a bricklaying house building company.
Really?
And that's how he started getting going.
Really?
100%. They just started building houses and laying bricks.
I mean...
After the earthquake, when everybody's properties crumbled.
I mean, just think about that. Comes over, does that. Becomes Mr. Universe multiple times.
Yes.
Becomes a global... phenomenon. Forget even bodybuilding. A movie.
Movie mogul. Marries a Kennedy.
Becomes governor of California. And then what does he do?
Bangs the ugly housekeeper.
The ugly housekeeper.
I know. He didn't make my list.
I can't believe it. All right.
I didn't know where to put him.
All right. That's ridiculous. All right, go ahead.
Didn't make my list. Right. I said, this is my list.
Yes, this is your list. Come up with my own list.
The fact that Arnold didn't make it, and now you're going to hear my number 10.
Oh, my God.
You might turn this whole thing off.
You might lose in points.
My number 10.
Yeah.
Dean Cain.
Okay.
Now, Dean Cain.
Yes.
You know, accomplished in terms of Hollywood.
Yep.
Right?
Yep. Superman.
I think he ran into issues, right? He did something.
He pissed someone off.
Did he beat someone up?
They blackballed him.
He had an issue.
Yeah. They
played for the Buffalo Bills.
That's right. Yeah.
Went to Princeton?
Princeton.
Right?
Yeah.
He's my number 10.
All right.
Okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I mean, we could talk about the Arnold thing forever. We'll probably get back to it. Yeah. I just didn't know what to do with him. Didn't put him on.
Yeah.
It is what it is. That's my number 10. My number 9, I love this one. I don't know why I do, but I do. I love this one. Tony Danza. My number 9.
Don't tell me he was a boxer.
12 professional fights. He went 9-3.
That's right. When you put boxing right up there then with bodybuilding as media...
No.
Because it's still a professional sport.
If he's getting punched in the face.
Yeah, that's true.
The dumbbells don't punch back.
That's true.
I have
weights don't hit back.
I love this song, by the way.
Yeah.
Number 2, I have the ultimate respect for bodybuilders, what they do,
right.
Lifting weight, all that stuff. I'm not... Yeah. Right. I just didn't know where to put him.
Right, okay.
But Tony Maselli,
yeah,
a.k.a. Tony Danza, from What was the name of the show?
Oh, Laverne and Shirley.
Oh, right? He started there.
Hey, he was a big ragu.
The big
he was
ragu.
A big ragu.
But then he was Tony Maselli on the show he starred in with
Tony Danza?
Yes. Yeah. He was the nanny. He was the babysitter, the housekeeper. Alyssa Milano was the daughter.
Oh.
What was the name of that show?
Someone knows the name of
I don't know how.
Who's
I don't
the boss?
Know. Who's the boss?
Thanks, Jay.
So he's my number nine.
Lucas comes
9-3
big.
Yeah. In professional fights.
All right.
9-3.
Yeah.
I love my number nine.
Yeah.
I love my number eight even more. Like, this is fantastic. My number eight. Played a character on TV for an extended period of time on a show that was fantastic and also did a lot more in Hollywood. Went to Morehead State, I believe, played football, got drafted by the Pittsburgh Steelers. I never would have thought. Got drafted by the Pittsburgh Steelers. Al Bundy, Ed O'Neill was my
Did
number
really?
Eight.
Really?
Got drafted by the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Yeah. He played at...
Morehead State, I believe.
That's out in Kentucky.
Kentucky, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Who knew?
You're right.
Who knew?
Who knew? He He looked like a good football coach in Little Giants. I don't know if you know that movie.
Yeah, I do. I remember that. But don't you remember him in the Bundys?
Yes.
He would, you know, he was getting a washed up high school football
I believe
player.
He went to Polk High.
Polk High, yes.
Right? Yeah. So.
For do you like Al Bundy better or Ed O'Neill better as Al Bundy or the role he plays on Modern Family?
It's such a toss-up.
He's brilliant on Modern Family.
He's good in everything.
He really is.
Right?
Right. He is.
I know he doesn't get like critical acclaim usually,
but
he's good in everything.
You know, he just seems like he would be a guy if you saw a famous person you saw at a bar and you bought him a drink and he appreciated it and just...
Yes.
Right.
I believed he was a shoe salesman who hated his life. Like he was in Married with Children.
Yeah.
Who had a slutty daughter and a son that was a midget and was, you know, all that.
What's the name of his business that he has in Modern Family? Like closets, closets, closets.
Yeah,
right?
Like, you would believe he would do that.
Right. Like he,
But.
Yeah.
He was my number eight.
Yeah.
So, my number seven's an icon in the Hollywood world.
Yeah.
Played football for Florida State. Was one of the best high school football players in the country of his time. Went to Florida State. Probably had a pro career that he was looking at. Suffered career-ending injury after his freshman year.
I got it.
You probably know. Burt Reynolds.
Yeah. The greatest. And who was his roommate?
I know this. Lee Corso.
Lee Corso.
Was his roommate.
How about that for a pair?
What's going on in that room?
Lee Corso and Burt Reynolds.
What was going on in that room?
At Florida State back in the 60s?
God. What wasn't going on in that room? Right?
Could you imagine that?
No.
First of all, Burt Reynolds, I mean, he was the coolest dude. Every woman wanted him.
Yes.
Every guy wanted to be him, right?
Yeah.
And then he played the quarterback in, what was it? The
Longest Yard.
Longest
the original Longest Yard.
Yeah.
Not the Adam Sandler version.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. Burt Reynolds.
Burt Reynolds.
Yeah. Carl Weathers.
No, let's not.
Jay's on it.
We're getting there.
Yeah, Burt Reynolds, great call. But honestly, Florida State in the 60s, Lee Corso and Burt Reynolds. How's that?
What kind of stories could they have? I mean, unfortunately, Reynolds can't tell them anymore, but
right.
Corso.
Did you ever see that meme, Happy Birthday?
Oh, yeah. Isn't there a picture of like Burt Reynolds with just a cowboy hat?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Nothing else on?
Yeah.
Like...
Why did he? Smoking the Bandit. He was phenomenal in Smoking the Bandit. Yeah. Burt Reynolds. Rest your soul, Burt.
Pulled off the fake hair. Nobody even cared.
No.
But he was married to Lonnie Anderson?
He was. And he married Lonnie Anderson. In her prime.
WKRP in Cincinnati,
right
by
there,
the way,
Herb,
which we love.
Herb Tarlick tried to go after, you know?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Herb had nothing on Burt.
Nothing.
Nothing.
He was my seven.
All right.
Fantastic.
All right. So,
my sixes might be a little obscure, but maybe not.
Yeah.
This gentleman played in the NFL for 13 years. I didn't realize this. Star of a TV show that I remember watching when I was young, growing up. Hunter. Fred Dreyer.
Fred Dreyer, that's right.
Yeah.
He played for the Rams?
Rams.
He was defensive end,
I think. Yes, 13 years.
Yeah.
I didn't know he played that
Imagine
long.
Imagine that.
I didn't know that.
Man, I mean, you know he's smoking cigarettes the whole time. Oh, yeah.
Smoking everything
right.
the whole time. Come on.
Yeah.
And... Hunter, and on top of other things, but he was
Fred
known
Dreyer.
For Hunter.
Yeah.
He was the lead in that.
And a cool dude. He played in a lot of other stuff, too.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hunter's the one I always remember. Like, right. I just remember watching that show. So
Dreyer, good call.
He was my six. He's my six.
All right.
My five is the aforementioned Carl Weathers.
Yeah.
Right? Now, his Carl Weathers played for the Oakland Raiders. I think he appeared in 8 games total.
Yeah.
But then when you flip it and see what he did in Hollywood, he was very sports-related in Hollywood, too. Between Apollo Creed, which was the iconic role, all the way down to Chubbs from Happy Gilmore,
yeah.
who's the alligator ate his hand.
Yeah.
You know.
He was drafted by the Giants. Is that what
but,
he it,
but he played in the NFL for the Raiders. He played in 8 games for the Raiders.
All right.
So.
And just another likable guy.
Yeah. You would think.
Yeah.
Action Jackson.
Action
that was one,
Jackson.
Right? Action
yeah.
Jackson.
Yeah.
Apollo Creed is the one. Like,
it's the one.
The one. But again, Chubbs did from Happy Gilmore.
Did his son play in Creed?
No, I think that was Michael Jackson, right? Who played the lead?
Oh, I gotcha.
Was it? Yeah, I could be wrong.
Fact checking.
I hear those are great movies. I haven't seen any of them for some reason. I should. I hear they're really good.
Yeah, Action Jack. Yeah.
Is it Michael?
Oh, Creed and Creed 2?
Yeah, I heard it's fantastic.
Fantastic, yeah.
So, he's my five. So now we're in the top four,
right?
This is the sweet spot. Four, probably no surprise, still controversial to this day. One of the best running backs of all time, probably. His movie and TV, like the IMDb list on this guy, was much more than I thought it was.
Right.
O.J. Simpson. Appeared in the Naked Gun series.
Mm-hmm.
Went from the NFL to Hollywood to various other things.
Yeah.
But you got to put him in the top four, in my opinion. In terms of how good he was as the athlete and then everything he did in Hollywood, he did a lot.
Yeah.
He was in a lot of movies. I didn't realize till I looked. So
he was in. Was he in Top Gun? Was he in Top Gun?
No.
He wasn't in Top Gun.
No.
I thought he wasn't. Wasn't a scene in a hospital where they brought him out to like a football or baseball game in the
hospital? That was Naked Gun.
Naked Gun.
Yeah. When he was in the wheelchair and he fell down.
Naked Gun. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
He popped up.
Yeah. He kicked his own ass in the opening scene of Naked Gun. Like they were jumping on a ship and stopping someone from illegally importing stuff.
Right.
And they bust in on the bad guys, and he then falls over. Then he puts his hand on the hot stove.
That's right.
And then he just beat himself up.
OJ.
Yeah, OJ.
Fucking OJ.
So he was my four.
Yeah.
My three, from an athletic perspective, is one of the best to ever play his sport. Also had a pretty extensive Hollywood career. Probably a little bit of a controversial guy. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Yeah.
Definitely was on Different Strokes. Definitely had a cameo on basically all those shows.
I don't remember him on Different Strokes.
Yeah.
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 I just, just Airplane. I mean.
Airplane, which was.
Right.
I mean, you can't.
Have you ever been in a cockpit of an airplane before?
Yeah, right. Right.
You ever seen a grown man naked?
Yeah. Right.
Right.
So.
Yeah.
You got him. Airplane alone puts him in the top four, in my opinion.
It's the best.
Especially, you know what's funny? Like, he's such a serious guy. Like, from what you know of him now, like, he's such a serious guy, but he was in movies like Airplane, right? Like, you wouldn't think he would be, but.
I told this story. I think I told the story on the show when I met him.
Yeah.
What a really interesting and nice man.
I bet.
Yeah, really kind. Just you know, one of these guys that just really respectful and knew that people wanted to talk to him and take their picture with him and you know.
Which is rare.
Yeah, he was great.
He let some jabroni like you take up a couple minutes of his time.
Right. And ask a question. How'd you like, start an airplane?
Right.
Everybody else was asking him, political questions.
Yeah, right. About the cause.
Diversity.
The cause.
Yeah, the cause. And I pop up with,
right.
So I was a plane captain on an airplane.
Right.
Fred the Hammer Williamson.
I expect
nothing
less.
Oh, is that what his name?
Fred the Hammer.
Fred the Hammer Williamson.
Yep.
Yeah. Very nice, Casey.
So.
All right.
Jabbar gets my three.
All right.
Back to the NFL, one of the best of all time. He was in a movie called Any Given Sunday, directed by Oliver Stone. Jim Brown.
Oh, man.
And Jim Brown did a lot, actually. He did another guy that you don't know, you don't realize. He was in a fair amount of motion pictures, a fair amount of TV stuff.
He was.
He took it to that level.
Yeah.
So Jim Brown gets my number two, again, based on his catalog in Hollywood, and then obviously what he did on the field.
Yeah.
He's probably, it's a different topic for a different show, but he's got to be top three running backs of all time.
Jim Brown?
Right?
Without a doubt.
Maybe top two. We could probably say top two right now without even having the argument.
But, you know, no one touched him when he played. I mean, he was the...
the guy.
For a long time.
Very good lacrosse player, too.
He was an All-American lacrosse player, yeah. too, wasn't he?
Yes.
All-American lacrosse
player. So he's arguably top two, top three running back of all time.
Yeah, Jim Brown and LT, yeah. Yeah.
LT was also in that movie.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, that's
LT
funny.
LT was in that movie.
Yeah, that's funny. Yeah, Jim Brown. And did you see him at the draft this year? Did
yes.
Did we mention that?
Oh, yeah.
He got up
we
and,
talk, oh, yeah.
yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it was classic.
Yeah. You're probably going to get that from Jimmy every time,
and
right?
He should. At maybe he did point. It on purpose.
Yeah.
Right?
I would think.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
He was my two.
Yeah.
We're now at that top spot. I think it's probably a no-brainer.
It's getting down to it now, yeah.
But, I mean, this guy didn't have the pro career, but once he got off the field, he's transcended himself into a household name. I went with Dwayne Johnson as my one.
Yeah, good call.
He, from what I understand, again, the fact-checking we do here is minimal.
Yep.
But from what I understand, he has the top quote in Hollywood right now. If you want his services for a motion picture or TV, he has the highest price tag.
And he's also owns a production company,
yes.
too.
Yes, yes.
So they're producing movies and TV shows. And
a world-famous WWEF, whatever you want to call it, personality.
Yeah.
Who then transcended right into...
Yeah, but you see him in like...
Played for Miami.
Well, he played University of Miami, then played for the Calgary Stampede.
Yes. Right? He went to train. He went to training camp with someone.
Maybe.
In the NFL, I thought.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah. I like him. I like. I mean, who doesn't? I mean, the guy has 50 million followers on Instagram.
Oh, and yeah. And it's
maybe
him.
More,
it's him.
Maybe 100 million. He's crushing it.
He brings like a transportable gym with him everywhere.
Here he goes.
His workouts every morning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was in Jumanji 1. He's going to be in Jumanji Jumanji 2, the new one.
Yep.
Jungle Cruise.
Yep.
Yeah, he's the best. I saw him at which... I told you. Did I tell the story when I saw a premiere when I lived out in Burbank for Disney and I went to premiere of Witch Mountain?
Oh, Witch Mountain he was in, yes.
And
yes.
The direct, and it's really weird when you go to these premieres. And I was like, all premieres, I got to go to a Disney premiere, right? So I'm like, there's not going to be no booze here. Except for Amanda Bynes showed up and she was a drunken mess. But that's a whole different story.
God bless.
So the director of the movie gets up and... He was a horrible public speaker. Awful. And he sounded drunk. And so The Rock got up and basically crushed the introduction, the thank yous, and just no ums or just a top. You could tell that this guy's just been doing this forever. And he had a Make-A-Wish Foundation kid with him that sat up there. And he told the story about the kid and how he met the family. And they flew the family out there for this.
Wow.
And he brought the kid and the parents up on stage. And he told a wonderful... And it just tied it all back together. And people just... Everybody... I had a couple of tears in my eyes. Everybody gave him a standing ovation. And we're like, this guy's a rock star. And afterwards, we went back across the street for the post-movie party. And... And it's kind of weird when you go to a movie premiere, what they did. Well, this is what Disney does, is they basically have... it looks like you're walking into a wedding. And they have round tables with names on them. So it was kind of like David Spade had a table, and Rock had... And everybody kind of... The stars had tables, and people in the movie all had tables for their families, and they had tables for other people as well. But what Rock did, it was like he walked around to every single table like he was, you know... What he probably should have been doing, what every star should be doing, saying thank you. But it was, you know, they made that movie probably a year prior to when it came out.
Yeah.
So hadn't seen a lot of people in a long time, and you could just see his affection. I mean, he came around to our table, and everybody got up and took a picture with him, and it was really, really cool. It was really cool, and it was just what you think he is. Just a real genuine guy, and freaking... We kind of took a picture, and I had a client with me, and I put my arm around his shoulder, and it was like a pile of rocks I was holding.
Like granite?
It was granite. I was like, holy cow, this guy's made of armor.
Yeah.
Right? I couldn't even imagine him coming bull rushing off the line. I couldn't imagine that guy. You know, so anyways.
Goes to show you, though,
yeah,
how much talent the NFL players have, right?
Yeah. Yeah. And he didn't even make it.
That's what I mean.
Yeah.
Like, imagine that.
Yeah.
So.
So, anyways, The Rock.
He's my top. That's my list. Sticking to it.
All right.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah.
I had trouble with that one.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know.
A lot of NFL guys. You notice that?
Yeah.
I wonder if there's something there. I don't know what that is.
It's just, you know, they're used to pretending.
I guess.
Yeah.
Right.
So that's it. Hey, listen, our hot box, we got it in, 4:43. We got the show in on a Tuesday. Thank you, everybody, for joining us, as usual, throwing out the questions. All right, a couple from Jamie. Merlin Olsen, Mickey Rourke.
Mickey Rourke got into the boxing realm.
Yeah.
Destroyed that. Yeah. Those baby doll looks that would have made him a leading man.
Right. He turned into a freak, right? What he did to his face.
Fantastic actor.
Oh. That one movie he did, the wrestling movie? That was incredible. With Marissa Tomei. Bruce Lee, Chuck Norris.
I thought of the martial arts guys.
Oh, he is martial arts, yeah.
But Delta Force 1-7.
Right.
You know, all of those.
Right.
Walker, Texas Ranger. Yeah. Bruce Lee was the one that crossed my mind. Yeah. He did.
Yeah. John Cena's in there.
Yeah. Do you see me now, John Statt? I get it.
What was it, Stepfather?
And the one where he was the Marine and everyone was trying to kill him. I get it.
Right.
You know what I didn't put in?
Jamie's saying Jim Brown should have been number one based off the greatest running back ever. All right.
I gotta say, he might be right. This is why we do this.
Yeah.
You know who I omitted?
Yeah.
Who I thought I knew I omitted him, but I wanted to bring him up. Kurt Russell,
another one.
Minor League Baseball player.
Yeah, that's right.
A very accomplished in Hollywood.
Yeah.
Married Goldie Hawn.
He was in the original Witch Mountain.
Correct.
That's right.
Kurt Russell.
Yeah. Terry Bradshaw.
100%.
Terry Bradshaw. What was he in?
He was in stuff.
He played like the dad role in a couple of ones.
Yeah.
But
he played in that movie with Matthew McConaughey. Failure to Launch, I think. Yeah. He was the dad. I remember.
Yeah. Oh, that was fun.
This is why we do this.
This is why we do it. Thanks, Jay Bone. Thanks, Jay.
The top movie summer blockbuster list is coming.
It's coming out.
It's coming. It's going to be a top 25.
Oh, man. We're gonna need a two-hour show for that. We're going to need some Sailor Jerry rum.
It's coming. Yes. We'll gladly accept all gifts, all cards, all letters, especially those with checks in them.
Right.
Please send them.
All right, boys. Chris, thank you.
Keep grinding it out, everybody.
Ramble on, everybody. Sports Biz Podcast. See you next week. Do, 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 mom.